The Odes of Horace, B.C. 19. Justum et tenacem. The righteous man of purpose fixed and strong scorns the depraved commands of angry faction clamoring for wrong, nor fears the despot's frown. Not Auster's roar whitening the restless wave on Adria's shore, nor the red thunder hurled from Jove's avenging hands, can shake his solid will. Unmoved he stands, erect amid the ruins of a world. Thus rose Alcides to the flaming skies, thus Leda's son to those divine abodes, where couched among the immortals Caesar lies, drinking with purpled lip the nectar of the gods. Thus Bacchus clomb to Jove's Olympian throne, drawn by wild tigers ivy garlanded. Thus, strong and true, Rome's mighty founder sped, wafted by steeds of Mars to heaven, not Acheron. He claimed a throne among the gods. They sate silent. Then Juno rose. Troy met her fate, her god-built walls down crumbled into dust by a strange woman and a judge, unjust. Condemned by me and by Minerva's hate, since first that king, false to his kingly word, abjured his oath, withheld the pledged reward. Where now the glittering grace that shone from Paris on the adulterous queen? Where now the lustrous sheen sparkling from those false eyes, her faithless heart that won? Where Priam's perjured house, Hector's its stay, how oft his arm triumphant broke the Greek array? Dead is that 10 years' war, kindled by feuds of ours, its sound is heard no more. No more my anger rages, I resign to Mars this scion of a hated line, son of Troy's priestess. Founder of great Rome, enter among peaceful gods to find a home and quaff mid star-bright skies the nectar juice divine. So long as twixt his Rome and Ilian roll the billows of a boundless main, let Trojan exiles unmolested reign, let Rome's proud capital unshaken stand, while herds insulting Rome o'er Priam's grave, and while in Paris's tomb wolves hide their cubs. So long shall Roman valor, steadfast, strong, give laws to Medea's conquered hosts, and rule the Midland Ocean's coasts, and those far lands where fertile cornfields smile, fed by the waters of the swelling Nile. Great nation, that can't spurn the gold that in earth's bosom hidden lies, wisely there hid, unlike the base who turned to uses vile of sordid avarice, the temple's spoil, fearless your hosts send forth to India's sun-scorched wastes or the cloud-mantled north. Strong sons of Rome, to you my law I speak. Trust not your fortunes or your strength, nor seek, blinded by filial piety once more, the sentenced walls of Ilion to restore. If e'er again neath some ill-omened star she rises, I, Jove's sister, I, his wife, against her will lead the armies of my war, closing in new-lit flames her new-lit life. Should Phoebus thrice rebuild each wall, each gate, thrice shall my Argives raise them to the plain. Each widow thrice, captive and desolate, bewail her orphaned babes, her husband slain. Cease, sportive lyre, not thine mated with gods their counsels to explore. Fold, muse of mine, those wings too frail to soar, nor mock with mortal lips the voice divine.